Welcome back to my channel. I'm the Worm Whisperer, and today I'm going to go over how to feed your worms correctly. I've gotten a lot of questions on the forum and on my channel, and they're asking how to get bigger and fatter worms. So I'm going to go over with you on how to feed your worms correctly. And while it does come down to genetics a lot of the times and the type of worms that you're growing, you can help to get bigger, fatter, and more healthier worms if you're feeding them correctly. So today I'm going to go over and I'm going to teach you how to feed your worms correctly. Okay, so let's go over one of the most important things, and that's what do worms eat? So worms can eat a variety of scraps out of the kitchen, anything that's rotting in your fridge, lettuce, beans, any type of vegetable like that can be fed to your worms. Even if it's getting old, you can still feed it to your worms, and that is the best time to feed it to your worms. Once it starts to break down and get softer, that's when the worms are able to take it in and eat it the best. So one of the first things you want to do when you first get your worm bin is try to figure out if you have enough food scraps in order to feed your worms. So if you don't have enough food scraps, you may have to look around and ask your neighbors or your friends or your family and check with them, and they may be able to save some of their food scraps for you. So if you're not producing enough food scraps, you can get something called a worm mash. I don't recommend that just because it kind of defeats the purpose of having worms. If you want to use up your scraps around the house and stuff buying food for them, I don't generally think that's a great idea. But if you don't have enough food scraps, then it might be a thing that you can do in order to supplement the amount of food that they're getting. That's mostly what commercial growers do, is they'll go and they buy something called worm mash. And it's the same as any other type of feed you buy for animals, and they'll feed that to the worms. So today I've got some bananas here that I'm going to feed to the worms, and some of these are frozen and some of these are not frozen. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take this and I'm going to show you how to feed the worms today. So you can take a piece of the food like this, and a lot of people, what they'll do is they'll dig up a corner and then they'll set that food in the corner just like that. These stickers never broke down, but you can take them off. Okay, and you just stick the food in the corner like that, and then you can cover it up some, and that'll keep the bugs off it. And next time when you want to check that, you can go in, and all you have to do is just dig up a little bit like that, and then you can look in there and see if that food's gone. And if it's still there, then you know that the worms are still breaking it down. You don't need to feed anymore. So you can do that for all four corners of the worm bin. So you can put some in each corner and cover it over. Okay, so I got some of these old food scraps, some old carrots and some old banana peels. I'm going to put those in. So that's one way you can do it. So you can feed all four corners of your worm bin like that. And another way to feed is you can just essentially take the food that you have and just go over. Oh, don't need the tag in there. You can't break that down. And you just take the food and knock it out. You can see this stuff's already starting to break down some. And you just set it on the top. So you just take it and throw it on the top of the bin like this. And that way the worms will come up to the top to get it and eat it and then go back down into the bin when they've finished feeding. So what are some of the things that worms shouldn't eat? Well, that comes down to certain types of fruit, like any type of citrus fruit. One thing that you really want to steer clear of is garlic and onions. That stuff will actually burn their skin if you put too much of that in the bin. I wouldn't put any of that in the bin. So it's a good thing to avoid. So how do worms eat their food? So worms have essentially the exact same thing as a chicken. They have a gizzard. So what happens is the food is bitten off by the worm. The worms don't have teeth, so they can't chew the food. So what they do is they swallow it whole, and then it goes into their gizzard. And what the gizzard does is essentially grinds up the food together and makes it so the worm can digest it. Just like a chicken, they need sand, or they need ground eggshells or ground up rock, anything that has a ground, like a texture to it, that they can take in and using their gizzard to grind up the food that they're eating. So what state does the food have to be in? Well, it's got to be nice and soft in order for the worms to bite it off. It can't be hard. So the worms, they rely on aerobic activity in order to break down that food and break down the cell walls in the food in order for them to bite it off. So it has to break down a little bit before they're able to use it. How much food can a worm eat every day? A worm can essentially eat half their weight in food every day. So if you have one worm, it can eat half its weight in food scraps every single day. So if you have 1 pound of worms, it will be able to eat half a pound of food scraps every single day. Now, that being said, that's in an ideal environment, and I'm not sure if that's really the case all the time. The worms would have to be in a perfect environment and perfect health to eat that much. So it's going to vary from time to time whether they're eating that much or not. So one of the big keys to feeding your worms, and this might be the biggest key in the whole video, is make sure that you let the worms dictate how much they're going to eat every day. Paying close attention to how much the worms are eating is very important. You want to watch how much they're eating and then decide how much to feed them by how much they're consuming every single day. So one of the important things is, even if you have a bin that's running extremely well, it's really hard to figure out how much exactly in pounds of worms that you're going to have in there for any given time. If you've got a really healthy worm bin, you're not going to know how many pounds of worms are in there by how much they're eating every day, and not how much you think in pounds the worms are in the bin. It's also really important to note that they're also going to eat a lot of that carbon that you're putting in there. So a lot of that cardboard or any other type of carbon that you're putting in there, they're also going to be consuming that at the same time. So it's not like if they do run out of food for a couple of days, they're going to be starving as long as there's cardboard in that bin. So I would just make sure that you've got a bit of food in there just to get started, and that way you're always watching how much they're consuming. What are some good tips in order to help your worms consume their food faster? Well, one of the first things you could do is blend up or chop up your food. So you can take your food, throw it in the blender, or put it on a chopping block and chop it up, and that'll help it break down faster so the worms can get access to it. One thing that works even better than chopping up your food is to throw it all in a blender. So you can take old kitchen scraps like tomatoes and cucumbers, squash, anything like that, lettuce, and you can throw it in your blender and you can make what I call as a worm smoothie. So if you take all that stuff and you blend it up in the blender and make a worm smoothie, you can take that and feed your worms like that. So one thing that I do is I don't blend up mine. I just don't think it's useful to use that electricity to blend up your food if you really don't have to. So one of the things that I'll do is I'll freeze and thaw the food out for the worms. And you can do this as many times as you like. A lot of times what I'll do is I'll put a big bucket of food in the freezer, like a bowl full, and I'll freeze it. I'll take it out. I'll let it thaw. I'll throw a few fruit scraps in there. And then what I'll do is I'll put that back in the freezer, and then I'll do the same thing in a week's time. And it helps every single time that it freezes to break down the cell walls in their food, and it helps them to bite off the food and digest it easier. I like to feed my worms a lot of banana peels, and I find that that works really well for banana peels. It takes a little while for the banana peels to break down in the bin, so freezing them 2 or 3 times definitely helps to break down the cell walls. So my first tip is, make sure that you never ever feed your worms until they've consumed the food from the very last feeding. Just wash the bin and dig around a little bit and check in there and just make sure that there's no food left in the bin. And then if you see there's no food left, that's the best time to feed your worms, is after they've consumed all their food from last time. Also pay close attention to how long it takes them to eat that food that you put in from the last feeding. Another tip is if you have an outside worm bin, is that you can feed your worms a little more in an outside bin. It's helpful to do that, and you can also let your bin go a little longer with more food in it if your bin is outside. So if your bin is inside, one of the great things that you can do, and one of the tips I'm going to give you is that you can feed it a little bit less and feed it a little more often. And that way it'll help cut down the smell. It'll also help cut down the bugs in your bin. So one of the questions I get asked a lot is, do you need a worm sitter? And the answer to that is no, you don't need a worm sitter. So worms can go quite a while without any feed, and they can go quite a while without any attention. I wouldn't let them go too long, but I mean, I've seen people let worms go a month. As long as they've got food and carbon in there and they're being fed, they can live quite a while and they don't need a worm sitter. So if you're going on vacation or anything like that, there's nothing to worry about. You can just give them a little more feed and a little more carbon and mix it in there. Just make sure you don't put too much in, because you don't want to have a catastrophe when you come home. And if you do leave it for a while, you want to make sure that you check that bin as soon as you get home and just make sure everything's all right. And if they need more food, then at that point you can add some more food into the bin. Some of the cool things that you can feed to your worms around your house that you might not know is, one of the first ones is paper towel. So you can use paper towel to feed your worms. They don't mind that as long as you don't use it to clean up any chemicals or use it for any with any cleaning products. Then you can use that in your worm bin if you're cleaning up water or a spill or something like that. You can use that paper towel in your worm bin and the worms will break that down. Another one you can use is pet hair. So you can use, as long as they haven't had any chemicals or anything like that for fleas or ticks added to their fur, any fur that comes off your animals, you can use that in your worm bin. You just want to be careful that you don't put too much in at one time. It can clump up and it makes it hard for the worms to break it down. But if you just use it in smaller amounts, it's definitely something that you can add to your worm bin. So another one out there for all you coffee drinkers is the coffee grinds and the coffee filter. You can also put that in your worm bin. The worms will break that down as well and make that part of your worm castings. So here's one that a lot of people talk about, and I don't know if I particularly agree with it. It's dryer lint. And a lot of people say you can throw dryer lint in the worm bin, but I'm always concerned about microfibers. If you're using all cotton clothing that you made yourself, then it's probably a fine idea. So if you're using a lot of synthetic type clothing in there, there's going to be microfibers that come off of there that the worms can't break down. And then you're adding those microfibers into your bin. I don't really agree with that. I don't think that's a great idea, but it's kind of up to you. I do see people that do add dryer lint, but myself, I don't add that just because of those microfibers. So that wraps up our video for today. I hope that it was useful. And I hope you got some information out of that. If you have, I'd like to hear your opinion on microfibers in dryer lint. If you'd like to leave a comment about that and tell me what your thoughts are, that would be great. I'd like to hear what your thoughts are on microfibers and adding them to the worm bin. And I want to thank everybody who's come out today to watch my video. Thank you very much for coming. And I hope you have a great day. Thank you. And don't forget to subscribe and like if you've learned anything in this video. Thank you.